Ma'am, can I ask you a question?
Sure.
What has brought you to Safeway today?
My car's messy. I need to make some cookies. It's a very important task.
You're making cookies, so you're here to get ingredients for your cookies?
Yeah.
All right. All right, Leah, so what's the first ingredient?
Raisins
is the first ingredient?
Raisins, yeah.
All right.
Second ingredient, molasses.
Perfect. What's this ingredient?
We need flour to make cookies, so.
I'm sorry, you didn't talk into the mic.
You are so irritating. Fourth ingredient.
Fifth ingredient,
baking soda.
Perfect.
Sixth ingredient, salt.
It's upside down.
Salt. Seventh ingredient, ground cinnamon. Ingredient number eight, old fashioned rolled oats.
Perfect.
Nine. Ingredient number nine, vanilla extract.
Perfect. They got the fidget spinners. That's gotta be ingredient number 10 right there. No.
Ingredient number 10, eggs. We need two of them, but. Ingredient number 11 is unsalted butter.
Can you substitute duck eggs for chicken eggs?
No harm in trying. Okay, we just got out of the store. I'm already using some ingredients for my house, so I only paid about $10 for what I needed. But we did add everything together. Everything in total would be $44.49 if you had nothing. So yeah, let's go home. We are making oatmeal raisin cookies. First, we need a cup of butter, so I already have that in here. Then we have a cup of brown sugar and then 1/4 cup of just regular sugar. Mm-hmm. We're gonna put this all in the bowl and we're gonna cream it together. Alrighty, now we're gonna scrape down the sides. We are going to add in a tablespoon of molasses and a tablespoon of vanilla. And then the molasses. Dude, this smells so gross. And we're just gonna mix this together until it's all combined. Alrighty, and now we will add two eggs. I already have them cracked. And work on the dry ingredients. Ingredients. Clean whisk. And then we have salt, baking powder, cinnamon, flour, and oats. So we're just gonna add.
What happened?
Huh?
What happened?
What do you mean? What happened?
Oof.
Oof. I don't know. I make sounds when I bake. An expressive person. Okay, so we just put the flour and the baking soda in. Now we are adding the salt and the cinnamon. And we're gonna mix this together before we add the oats. Okay. Now we're gonna add the oats in. This is 3 cups of oats. Ever seen this quantity of oats in a bowl?
That is a lot of oats.
Yeah. I hope that bowl is big enough. I'm gonna grab that green thing. Okay. Then we are going to add our dry mixture of oats, flour, baking soda, and cinnamon. It smells very good. Into this bowl. And then we're gonna mix that all together. I put this little green thing on there to stop stuff from flying out. when I mix it. I am so scared. And then we are going to mix it till it is all combined, and then we will add the raisins in. We can turn off the oven because we have to let this chill for 30 minutes in the fridge. So I'm gonna go turn off the oven real quick. And then we're gonna add the raisins. This is just a cup of raisins. And hope that this mixer can mix everything in. This is very thick, very tough to get through. Okay, I think that should be good. And then we're just gonna pop this in the fridge for 30 minutes. We can find space in the fridge. There we go. And we will be back in 30 minutes. Most researchers agree that Fannie Merritt Farmer wrote the first recipe for oatmeal raisin cookies in 1896. They quickly became popular as they were considered a healthier alternative to other baked goods. Quaker Oats started putting oatmeal raisin cookie recipes on their oatmeal containers as early as 1900s. I don't think they're a very healthy alternative other than raisins, but I don't think raisins are the healthiest either.
I mean, there's oats in it too.
I mean, yeah. Here. And it says to roll two tablespoon sized balls, but I don't really want to measure that, so we're just gonna eyeball it and hope for the best. My nails are too long for this. It's about 2 tablespoons. I hope that these 2 baking sheets are enough. Not a very sociable cat.
Yeah,
I feel like that's more of a reasonable size.
Hold on. Sorry guys, your portion sizes are getting lowered a little bit.
I hope no one's allergic to any like raisins or anything.
Well, then they just won't eat it.
That's true.
You need to tell them what's in it.
You know, I came downstairs the other day and I looked at my mom and dad and I was like, Mom, Dad, people have been telling me to start like making jokes about old people in retirement, but none of them work. But you can try.
Yeah, you could probably layer them or something.
Well, you're not really supposed to layer things. Oh, man. Oh, wait, hold on. Oh! Okay. Ta-da!
I think that works.
Only 23% of people like oatmeal raisin cookies.
Only 23%?
Yeah.
That's not surprising.
Bake for 12 to 14 minutes until lightly brown on the sides. The center will look very soft and underbaked. No, those don't look like they're light and like brown and crispy on the sides. Those still look underbaked.
I agree.
They smell good. Do you smell them?
I do smell them.
Dad, do you smell them?
Yeah. Stop trying to rizz up our classmates.
I'm sorry, it's in my jeans.
Jeans are ripped.
Most important thing about baking is having fun. Can't have fun, then you're not doing it right.
Now I'm starting to smell it.
Yeah, they do smell good.
Yeah.
Those look funky. I don't want to burn you. They look very dark. I feel like we overcooked them.
Maybe a little bit, but I feel like that fits the description.
What do you mean?
Of like what it said we're supposed to take about when they look like this. Perfect.
step number six, well, the final step, I feel like it's kind of a given. Take them out of the oven. We let them cool on the baking sheets themselves for about 5 minutes and then transfer them onto like a cooling rack. And that's the last step. Now you have cookies.
What a wonderful phrase.
Yeah, enjoy.
Hakuna Matata. Ain't no peasant craze.
It means no word.